With virtually all the votes counted now in the French presidential election, the margin of Emmanuel Macron's win has risen even higher. 66.06% of people voting for Macron as he tells his supporters the world is waiting for us, defend the spirit of the Enlightenment threatened in so many places. Marine Le Pen says her party must now reinvent itself as she calls on all patriots to join a new political force. She also says her National Front party will adopt a new name for the fight ahead. And attention here in France now, turning to the legislative elections in a few weeks' time. The far-left Jean-Luc Mélenchon warning that Macron will destroy France's social system. We're going to be discussing that shortly with his spokesman on the programme. So everyone said it was impossible, but they didn't know France. Emmanuel Macron, as he thanked his supporters at a massive party in front of the Louvre Museum, those supporters who'd only joined him since he formed his political movement en marche just 1 year ago. Now, though, after what must be France's most unusual presidential election ever, Macron promised to serve the country with love as he admitted to the immense task to rebuild European unity, fix the economy, and ensure security against extremist threats. Macron said the world is watching us and waiting for us to defend the spirit of the Enlightenment threatened in so many places. So in the end then, let's have a look at those final figures coming in, showing Macron did do far better than predicted. Some polls only a few days ago, in fact, showing him on 58%, but in the end he won by a convincing 66%. This report then from Brian Quinn.
From a simple set at his campaign headquarters, Emmanuel Macron greeted his victory with a solemn acknowledgement of the hard road ahead.
My responsibility will be to gather all women and all men to face the gigantic challenges waiting for us and to act.
The gravity of his address, a notable departure from the triumphant tone that marked his first place finish in the first round of voting 2 weeks ago, a celebration some observers criticized as being premature. But at a victory rally in front of the Louvre Museum, the festive mood of Macron's supporters could not be denied, and the new president-elect obliged. Taking the stage to the strains of Beethoven's Ode to Joy, the official anthem of the European Union, Macron finally allowed himself to publicly enjoy the moment.
Merci d'être là.
Thank you for being here, for fighting with courage and kindness for all these months. Because yes, tonight, this is a win for you. This is a win for France.
Even in triumph, he recognized the divisions that led nearly 11 million of his fellow citizens to vote for the far-right National Front.
Today they have expressed their anger, their dismay, and for some, their convictions. I respect them. But I will do everything in the 5 years to come, so there is no more reason to vote for the extremes anymore.
Pour les extrêmes.
Healing those divisions will be one of the biggest challenges facing Macron as he prepares to begin his five-year term.
Well, Macron's supporters of the Louvre, of course, loving that speech. Let's hear from some of them last night.
He's a young president. He was unknown 3 years ago. It's a disruption for us here in France and in politics. And that's something really exciting, and what really gives us hope.
Macron's speech is the one which we were expecting. It was up to the task. It will reunite all the French and develop more optimism than we've ever had before.
He's a candidate of the system. Globalization is a fact, and he's part of it. So let's do it. Let's try it out. We can't fight it, so let's go with it. And we'll see if it works or not.
Well, let's talk to some of our guests here on set. With me still is Aurélien Mondon, who's a senior lecturer in French and comparative politics at the University of Bath. And also joining us this half hour is Jean-Jean Kuzmanovic, who's a spokesman for the far lefts, or lefts, as he will argue, Jean-Luc Mélenchon, particularly on international and security affairs. Thanks to both of you for being with us. Relief from you and your party that we don't have a National Front government?
Oh, yes. We are very happy. And At the first round, Mr. Mélenchon said that Le Front National has to be blocked, but there is a different mean to do it, voting for Mr. Macron or just not voting, which was the choice that made some of the insoumis in France. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we're happy that we don't have the shame to have an extreme right president in France.
Some people would say, though, that actually Jean-Luc Mélenchon should have gone a lot further, and this win isn't thanks to him. I mean, it could have been that Le Pen could have been elected because he didn't say to his voters, vote Macron.
No. Mr. Macron is a product that was brought there by a system, and everything was organized to have the second round, which is a catastrophe at the end for our democracy, to have a far-right extremist that could be president. And everything was organized, even the last 10 days of before the first round. Remember what happened then. Even the French president, Mr. François Hollande, said that who has a problem with democracy, who likes the dictators, it's not Madame Marine Le Pen, is Mr. Mélenchon. So everything was done not to have Mr. Mélenchon on the second round, which would have been far more complicated for Mr. Macron, because he would have had fight on the program, which he didn't. Our choice was right, because we know that there is many people that are afraid, especially popular people that are afraid by the program of Mr. Macron, which is very... It's super capitalist. It will destroy what was built by the French Republic regarding social security, healthcare, and we don't want it for him to have a stronger support by the French.
Okay, well, let's hear actually what your leader then, Jean-Luc Mélenchon, had to say last night, because he came out fighting, sounding quite combative after the result. He called on his supporters not to vote for Le Pen, as we said, but much criticism of him as well for not calling on people to vote directly for Macron. And he's told his supporters now to prepare for battle in the legislative elections in a few weeks' time, amid fears from him, as our guest said, that Mr. Macron, will destroy France's social system.
Le programme du nouveau monarque présidentiel est connu.
The programme of the new president monarch is well known. It's a war against this country's hard-earned social benefits and a promotion of environmental irresponsibility. But this is not a fatality.
Après un vote de refus et de peur, le moment est venu.
The upcoming parliamentary elections must show that, after a vote of rejection and fear, the time has come for a positive choice, to build the future together. I call on the 7 million people who voted for my programme to remobilize and remain united, whether they voted for Mr. Macron or not. I call on all those who want to break away from the past to join our movement.
Yeah, Aurelio Mondron, I mean, he calls there for a positive vote, but he did sound pretty combative. It sounds like he's not going to make it easy for Emmanuel Macron, is he?
No, I don't think it will make it easy for Emmanuel Macron. And I think it is important that he doesn't make it easy for Emmanuel Macron. I think a lot of people on the left, on the broad left, you know, from the Socialist Party to the far radical left all the way to Poutou and so on, have said that, you know, yeah, of course, we want to defeat the Front National. Some voted for Macron to defeat the Front National. Others decided to abstain. But the aim was to defeat the Front National. And then the next day, today, Monday, the day after, we would start fighting against Macron's politics. So, of course, he will not make it easy. And I think it is important that in France we do have different political alternatives, because I think that's what made the first round what it was. You know, Marine Le Pen was predicted to get 30% in the first round with about 30% abstention. Instead, we got around 21% abstention and Marine Le Pen on 21%. And, you know, this is very much due to the fact that a lot of people found in Jean-Luc Mélenchon, in La France Insoumise, in the left in general, an alternative, something that spoke to them in many ways. I think the risk now is for the France Insoumise to go into bitterness in many ways, to go into kind of conspiracy theories and to go into a bit of a negative spin. I think it's very important that they offer France a positive alternative to what the Front National has tried to offer, particularly people in the suburbs, people who are suffering from globalization and capitalist globalization in particular.
Isn't there just a risk, though, that actually that just means everything becomes blocked? Because let's face it, Emmanuel Macron did get 66%, which is a pretty good vote here. But if he can't then actually do anything, what's the point?
That's right. I mean, there's a risk of everything being blocked, but that will very much depend on the legislative election. But I think the biggest risk would be to have a broad coalition from, let's say, you know, Les Républicains all the way to the radical left governing with Macron. And then we would risk having Marine Le Pen as the only alternative in 2022. And we saw that this is what happened happened, you know, in the last 5, 10, even 15 years, in a way, when the centre-right and the centre-left have converged, therefore giving her almost this kind of, you know, space to occupy where she represented the people against the elite. This is, I think, very important, that it's very important that this doesn't happen, because we don't know what Macron wants to do yet, and we don't know who he's going to govern with or anything like this. So I think scrutiny is going to be very important from all sides of a political spectrum, and particularly on the left, as we saw that there is an appetite for left-wing politics. There was, of course, Jean-Luc Mélenchon, but there's also Benoît Hamon, who ran a rather radical campaign compared to what we used to from the Socialist Party in the past couple of decades, really.
OK, well, Georgia Kuzmanovic, do you not think that Emmanuel Macron should be given a little bit of leeway here? As I said, he did get 66% of the vote. I mean, people will be expecting here in France for some of his ideas and programmes to actually make it, won't they?
Oh, my God, I hope no. I agree completely what Aurélien said. No, we hope that he will not have it, and that we are rather positive for the legislative. Yes, Mr. Mélenchon is combative, because now is the real fight for the program, and that's the third round of these elections, and it's very important. And we really want to have Mr. Mélenchon as a prime minister, so that we will have lefty socialist politics, and not that one that will destroy, as it was said by your commenter, the social benefits in France.
I mean, it's a very different race, isn't it, the legislative race? A lot of people will vote for their own particular individual candidates rather than having Jean-Luc Mélenchon as that overall figurehead, perhaps.
It's a bit true, but on the other way, these elections are just following the presidential one. Just 1 month after, and it's very influenced by the presidential election. And plus, here it will be complicated for Mr. Macron, because once again, he is a kind of product. He was sold as a young guy, new, fresh, even if it's not true. But the problem now is that he have people will vote for 577 people, that they are not always clear who they will be. Some are coming from the Parti Socialiste, former coming from the right parties, which will be complicated to explain to the French what is actually their program. And as Aurélien said, it's really not clear, except what we have seen from him these last 5 years, because he was one of the strongest supporters of Mr. Hollande. He was a second secretary in the Élysée, and then he was a Minister of Economy. Excuse me, he is one of the responsible of the economic situation in which we are. He is responsible of the laws by one is held by his name, Mr. Macron law, mm-hmm. then El Khomri law, mm-hmm. that are all against social benefits. So, yeah, I'm not sure that they will win this election. And I hope so.
I mean, it is very difficult to predict. As I was saying to Aurélien earlier on, that there were some polls last week saying that Macron could actually get almost 50% of the seats in the legislatives. But then you've also got, obviously, yourselves and the Republicans and the Socialists all trying to get back into the battle as well. It's almost impossible to predict, perhaps.
Yeah, this election it's very new. This is the first time that at the first round of the presidential election, we have, in fact, four parties that are pretty much at the same level, which is from 19 to 23, and which is all about 7 million voters. So it's not exactly clear what parliament will come out from this election. So, yeah, it will be a real fight, and we are prepared for it.
Okay.